Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You're very welcome here at the Cathedral. My name is Thomas Wilson, and I'm the Director of Music here. That means it's my job, along with the organist and our cantor, to do my very best to help you to sing God's praises here in this beautiful building. Singing at Mass is first and foremost a dialogue between the celebrant, in this case Archbishop Fisher, and the congregation. That sung dialogue is more important than singing hymns or parts of the Mass or anything else. So when the Archbishop sings, "The Lord be with you," I hope that you will all respond heartily and with your spirit. But first of all, we're just going to look at some of the sung responses. Now, these have all been designed to be as easy as possible. You all come from different parishes, and there won't necessarily be very much musical repertoire that you all know. So all the music in this book is specially designed with that in mind. If you turn to the first page of music, that's on page 5 in the red book, you'll see where it says Order of Mass and the processional chant. This is what we sing whilst the bishops process up to the altar. It's very simple. I'm going to sing it to you once. See if you can memorize it and then sing it back to me.
I will give you a new heart. I will put a new spirit within you.
Your turn.
I will give you a new heart. I will put a new spirit within you.
Turning on. On page 6, you'll see the Lord have mercy. This is very simple indeed, and our cantor, who you'll be pleased to know has a much nicer voice than I do, will sing each phrase, and then we'll all repeat them after her. But just to practice that, this is how it's going to go.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Repeat.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Thank you, couldn't be easier. And over on the right-hand side of that page, page 7, you'll see the Gloria refrain. I think this is rather well known throughout the Archdiocese. It's from Mass Shalom by Brother Colin Smith, and it goes like this.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Your turn.
Glory to
on page 8, you'll see the response to the responsorial psalm. Again, very simple. I hope with some of these melodies that they'll sound like you might know them, even though you could be hearing them for the first time. Again, I'll sing you this, and then we'll all sing it together.
Send forth your spirit, O Lord, and renew the face of the earth.
Together.
Send forth your spirit, O Lord, and renew the face of the earth.
That's getting better and better. I think I could hear something that time. Well done. A few pages over, on page 13, you'll see where it says the Liturgy of the Eucharist, and we have another one of these responsorial things to sing during the preparation of the altar. I'll sing it once and then we'll sing it back.
Confirm in us, O God, the good that you have done. We make ourselves an offering to you.
Your turn.
Confirm in us, O God, the good that you have done. We make ourselves an offering to you.
And of course, because there are verses sung by Josie the cantor, these responses keep coming back again and again, so I hope they improve every time we sing them. Over on page 14, you'll see the Sanctus, or Holy Holy. And this has been designed to sound, like I said before, to sound like you might know it even though you could be hearing it for the first time. I'll sing you a line, and then we'll all sing it together.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts.
It's your turn.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts.
Here's the next line.
Heaven and earth. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
And I can hear something coming back. That's a little bit exciting for me. Thank you. Let's continue with the rest of this from Blessed Is He. I'm not going to sing it to you this time. You'll see how it goes, I'm sure, and we'll sing it together. Follow the notes up and down. From Blessed Is He and
Blessed Is He. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Thank you. And you'll see on page 16, the Lamb of God is very similar.
Lamb of God, you take away.
Very much, and I do look forward to us all joining in all these sung responses. It's an important part of our participation in the Eucharist. Thank you.
I will put a new spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to this celebration of the Sacrament of Confirmation for the parishes of the Eastern Deanery. I decided this year to invite you to my place, so our young people might have a truly memorable confirmation ceremony and might experience the bigger church, that family of families, that community of parish communities that is the Sydney Archdiocese. I acknowledge in celebrating with me Auxiliary Bishops Terry, Tony and Richard, as well as Fathers John, Augusti and Rex. I welcome all the sponsors and families, teachers and catechists who are with us today. And to all of you, my young friends, who will be receiving the Sacrament of Confirmation, I say a very warm welcome. Conscious of the call of our baptism and confirmation to be saints for our world today, we repent of the times we've failed. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Stop. coming near and dwelling graciously within us, may make of us a perfect temple of his glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Lord says this, "Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom my soul delights. I have endowed him with my spirit that he may bring true justice to the nations. He does not cry out or shout aloud or make his voice heard in the streets. He does not break the crushed reed, nor quench the wavering flame. Faithfully he brings true justice." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If you are guided by the Spirit, you will be in danger of yielding to self-indulgence. Self-indulgence is the opposite of the Spirit. The Spirit is totally against such a thing, and it is precisely because these two are so opposed that you do not always carry out your good intentions. What the Spirit brings is very different. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You cannot belong to Jesus Christ unless you crucify all self-indulgent passions and desires, since the Spirit is our life, let us be directed by the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you,
Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it. But anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. What then will a man gain if he wins the whole world and ruins his life? Or what has a man to offer in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and when he does, he will reward each one according to his behavior." The Gospel of the Lord.
Your Grace, Archbishop Anthony, Bishop Tony, Bishop Terry, and Bishop Richard. The parents of each candidate and the parish priests present these candidates for the sacrament of confirmation and testify that they have been prepared by Holy Cross Parish Willara, Holy Family Parish Maroubra, St. Mary and St. Joseph Parish, Maroubra Bay, St. Bernard Parish, Botany, Our Lady of the Annunciation, Pagewood, and are ready to receive the sacrament of confirmation. We request that you confer the sacrament of confirmation to these candidates.
Thank you.
Baptism is obviously about washing. A special washing, of course, by which our old sinful nature is cleansed and we're given a fresh start, our beginning experience of grace, faith, church, saints. Holy Communion is fairly obvious too. It's about eating. A special eating, of course, as we participate in Jesus' Last Supper, when he gave us his all, even his body and blood, to be part of us. Reconciliation is about forgiving, but a special forgiving that reconciles us to God, each other, ourselves. Matrimony and holy orders are about committing, giving ourselves to each other in service as man and wife, man and church, and being received and loved in return. And holy anointing is obviously about healing, caring for the sick of body or soul, and bringing a promise of eternity. We can make sense of these sacraments because they are like things we do in ordinary life. Washing and eating, loving and forgiving, curing and caring. But confirmation, that's a hard one to explain, as many of the parents here must have found it in the last months. A hard one even for a bishop. Well, today I want to suggest confirmation is the sacrament that renews and promises all the other sacraments, all at once. Let me explain. Baptism is the sacrament of beginning, initiation, foundation. But so is confirmation. It gets you going. Jesus sent his disciples out to tell his story, to be his loving heart and hands, reaching out to all, especially those most in need. To make that possible, he sent the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, so that they would have the wisdom and courage they needed. I've endowed my servant with my spirit, he said in today's first reading, so he can bring true justice to the nations. Without that push, that empowerment, we call grace, we wouldn't dare do such things. But with them, even 10 and 11-year-olds on the cusp of Christian adulthood can share Jesus with the world around them. So confirmation is a bit like rewashing and resending, a second baptism. Like Eucharist, however, confirmation is a sacrament of connecting and communion. At Pentecost, people couldn't understand each other's languages. Then the Holy Spirit came and they could. Eucharist is like that too. Here in Sydney, it brings people from every background together to celebrate the one faith, hope, and love. We receive Christ's body so we might be united with him and together become his body, the Church. As the Holy Spirit does with the bread, so he does to our young people. Confirmation is like First Communion all over again, as Christ gives himself to you and you give yourself to him to be changed. But things fall apart. We've got big ideals, but sometimes we don't live up to them. We've got important relationships, but sometimes we let each other down. We've got God in our lives, but sometimes we neglect or disobey him. How to get back together with our ideals, people, God? Through confession, that sacrament too often neglected and now attacked in some places. There the priest announces to us that God sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins, and that by that Spirit's power, I absolve you from your sins. At the first Pentecost, the apostles were healed of their betrayal, cowardice, and confusion, and restored to friendship with God and each other. So confirmation today is like re-forgiveness, second reconciliation. Confirmation is also like marriage and ordination, because it's about commitment. We give ourselves to God, our highest ideals, the service of humanity. We say to our family, our friends, our church, the human race, I am yours, all yours, for better or worse, for richer or poorer. I'm an adult Christian now, ready to commit to big things. But will I see them through? Only by God's grace. So confirmation is like pre-ordination, pre-marriage. It gets us ready for more and better loving. But like our final anointing, confirmation is also a sacrament of completion. We use oil at the beginning of our adult life in the sacrament of confirmation, but also at the end in holy anointing of the sick. Oil massages, soothes, embalms. So whatever is hurting in your life, torn, broken, bring that to the Holy Spirit for healing. Already in your young lives, my friends, there is room for mending. There will be more bumps and bruises ahead. But any time you experience hurt in your body or heart, call upon the Holy Spirit. Confirmation is his promise that he will be there for you when hard times come and get you through the hardships, sickness, even death. So the Holy Spirit comes again and again through word and sacrament, and especially today in confirmation. When you are sealed with the Holy Spirit, he promises you, my young friends, fruits like love, joy, and peace, patience, kindness, and goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And he promises to be with you always, in everything you do. With his gifts, like wisdom and courage, you will do great things. And so, my young friends, there's a lot packed into this sacrament of confirmation. God wants to give you all this because he loves you so much and has big plans for you. Take part wholeheartedly in the rest of the Christian life, and you'll be amazed what can happen in you, with you, and for you. My fellow clergy, sponsors, leaders and catechists, family and friends of our candidates. Today our candidates will receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Help them apply those gifts in lives of Christian faith and practice, of virtue and holiness, of the worship of God and love for all. Candidates for confirmation, when you are anointed today, you will receive all you need to lead an adult Christian life, a life of loving and forgiving, curing and caring, communing and inspiring. It's a big task, but a wonderful one. And I know you can do this big thing. You can do it by praying, coming to Mass and confession, learning more about your faith, and doing good things in our world. The Holy Spirit will make this possible. So now I invite those who are to be confirmed to stand up and profess your faith before this assembly. And since this is a Sunday, I invite you all to stand with our candidates to profess your faith. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
If only the candidates would remain standing, please, the rest of you might sit. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father that these, his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin. Send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to God the Almighty Father and be of one mind in our prayer, just as faith, hope, and charity which proceed from his Holy Spirit are one.
For these his servants, whom the gift of the Holy Spirit has confirmed, that planted in faith and grounded in love, they may bear witness to Christ the Lord by their way of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their parents and sponsors, that by word and example they may continue to encourage those whom they have sponsored in the faith to follow in the footsteps of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who prepared them for this sacrament, that the Spirit of knowledge may continue to work through them in their mission, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God, together with Francis our Pope, Anthony our Bishop, and all the bishops, that gathered by the Holy Spirit, the Church may grow and increase in unity of faith and love until the coming of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole world, that all people who have one Maker and Father may acknowledge one another as brothers and sisters, without discrimination of race, of nation, and with sincere hearts seek the kingdom of God, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our communities, that the spirit of wisdom and understanding may help us to welcome and adore Jesus, the bread of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles and willed that through them and their successors, the same spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favorably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the reward of your holy church.
Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that, being conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him, as they share in the memorial of his redemption, by which he gained for us your Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us eternal offering to you, that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Mary the Cosmic Killer, and all the saints who our candidates have chosen as patrons this day, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Anthony, our Archbishop, his assistant bishops, Terry, Richard, me, your unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also, Lord, your servants reborn in baptism, whom you have been pleased to confirm by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and in your mercy, keep safe in them your grace. Listen graciously to the prayers of the family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ.
For the King.
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Let me say a word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness, and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Bishop Anthony, Bishop Terry, Bishop Tony, and Bishop Richard, candidates, sponsors, families, and friends. Today, a memory has been etched into our minds forever. We have been fortunate enough to receive the gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit as a group of young Catholics coming together to celebrate our confirmation, bonding us forever. The gifts and fruits have been sent to us by God to be used in the right way, so we can live like Christ. We pray they grow stronger each day as we put our faith in God and the Holy Spirit. And now, on behalf of all the candidates, sponsors, families, and friends here today at St. Mary's, we would like to thank you, Archbishop Anthony, Bishop Terry, Bishop Tony, and Bishop Richard, for helping us complete our journey in the sacrament of confirmation, and ask that you accept these cards as a token of our appreciation. Thank you.
Once again, we wish to thank His Grace, Bishop Terry, Bishop Richard, and Bishop Tony. It has been a wonderful experience celebrating this very special sacrament at St. Mary's Cathedral. Just a reminder to all parents, please note all confirmed candidates will be dismissed from the crypt. Once Mass has concluded, all confirmed candidates and sponsors will follow His Grace and bishops down the aisle and turn right to make their way down to the crypt. Candidates are to have their names marked off in the crypt before being dismissed. Parents and families, we ask you to please remain seated, and once all the children and sponsors have left the cathedral, you may exit via the side doors and make your way down to the external entrance of the crypt to collect your chart. Thank you.
Might I echo those words of thanks and add my own words of thanks to all those who've prepared our young people for tonight, as well as those who've celebrated with us. Not just those who've been preparing them these last few months, but the families who've been preparing them 10 or 11 years now to complete their initiation into the family of God, the Church. That's one chapter of your work complete. A new chapter begins as these young Christian adults go out into our world. And I think you'll find they need you as much as ever, your good example and encouragement for many years to come. you would pardon me telling you a story from when I went to one of the parishes celebrating confirmation with us today, the parish of Our Lady of the Annunciation, Pagewood, some many years ago. I went into the kindergarten class and immediately a little boy threw up his hand. "Excuse me, excuse me, excuse me." I said, "Yes." He said, "Do bishops get good pay?" I said, "Well, I don't know about that, but I said, priests have a wonderful life. They're close to God and close to people. They bring God and people closer to each other. Have you ever thought of being a priest?" I said. He looked at me. "A priest," he said, "a priest. They don't get good pay. We only put $1 on the plate." Some years later, I was back in the parish and I was telling them that story, and suddenly everyone was looking at a particular boy who was being confirmed that night. He was the boy that had said it to me when he was in kindergarten. Great to have Pagewood Parish back and all the other parishes of our Eastern Deanery. Let me tell you, there is no better pay for a bishop than the faces of our young people, so full of God, full of hope and idealism tonight. You keep that alive in them, all of you, their dear families. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit. And may he keep you worthy of his fatherly love. Amen. May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in his church, bless you and confirm you by his power in the confession of the true faith. Amen. And may the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of disciples, bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.